Now we are going to the exercise questions. The first exercise, first chapter, second exercise. Question number one, state whether the given situations are true or false. So just mention that whether the given statements are true or false. First statement, the difference between two rational numbers is a rational number. That means, think about the properties that we have checked. Difference between two rational numbers, a rational number. Whether the rational numbers are holding the closure property under subtraction. You have seen that when we subtract two rational numbers, the answer also will be a rational number. So the statement is true statement because it holds the closure property under subtraction. Second statement, the product of integers is commutative. Product of integers is commutative. Think about the commutative property. What is the commutative property? A into B is equals to B into A. So the product of integers, if you are taking the product between two integers and it holds the property A into B is equals to B into A. So the statement will be true statement always because it's obeying the commutative property under multiplication. Third statement, division of rational numbers obeys associative property. Division of rational numbers are not obeying the associative property because by dividing a rational number by another rational number, the associative property, that means A divided by B divided by C. A divided by B divided by C. In the case of rational numbers, this is associative property. They are not obeying the associative property. That statement, rational numbers obeys associative property, is a false statement. They are not obeying the associative property. So the given statement is a false statement. The last one, if a rational number is divided by zero, the result is a rational number. Any number, whether it is rational number or not, any number, if you are going to divide by zero, the result will be not defined, so we will not get any other result. We cannot say that the result is a rational number. The result is not defined, so the statement is a wrong statement, it is false. Question number two. Fill in the blanks to make the given statement true. First, 3 by 5 plus 7 by 9 equals to dash plus 3 by 5. You can compare the terms. It is commutative property. So 3 by 5 plus 7 by 9 equals to 7 by 9 plus 3 by 5. Commutative property under addition. Now the second one, 13 by 7 plus 18 by 5 plus 6 by 11 equals to dash plus 18 by 5 plus dash. It is associative property. You can check the right side. Left side, there are three terms, three rational numbers, two are in a group. So in the next side, another group will be there. So you can check with the first LHS, 13 by 7 plus 18 by 5. So 13 by 7 plus 18 by 5 will be in the group in the right side. That will be in the group, and 6 by 11 will be the last rational number. So if there is more parts, you can try by yourself. Then we will move to the next question. Verify the commutative property for addition for the following numbers. So this is the thing we have to check, commutative property, a plus b equals to b plus a. First one, minus 12 divided by 5 and 3 by 4. We have to check or verify the commutative property of addition between these two rational numbers. So minus 12 by 5 plus 3 by 4 equals to, according to the general form of this commutative property, a plus b equals to b plus a. We are applying that 3 by 4 plus minus 12 by 5. Then we have done the cross multiplication in both sides. 4 into minus 12, minus 48, 5 into 3, 20. Then 5 into 3, 15 divided by 5 into 4, 20. Right side, 5 into 3, 15, and 4 into minus 12, minus 48, divided by 20. Now calculate the numerators. LHS it will be minus 33 by 20. Right side also minus 33 by 20. So LHS is equals to RHS. Question number 4. And the third question, the remaining parts you can try by yourself. Now we are moving to the fourth question. Verify associative property for addition between the rational numbers. So this is our general form that we can make for the associative property of addition. A plus B plus C, where A plus B in a bracket or in a group, and A plus B plus C or B plus C in a group, and A stands alone. Substituting the terms, A is 4 by 5, B is minus 3 by 8, and C is 11 by 20. So 4 by 8 plus 5 plus minus 3 by 8 plus 11 by 20. 4 by 5 plus minus 3 by 8 in a group. Then 4 by 5 plus minus 3 by 8 plus 11 by 20, where minus 3 by 8 plus 11 by 20 is in another group. Now we are comparing. First of all, what are the calculations that we have to do is, inside the bracket you do the calculation, then after that we will either add or subtract or multiply with the term outside the bracket. First of all, inside the bracket you do the calculation, cross multiply, 8 into 4, 32, and 5 into minus 3, minus 15, 32 minus 15 divided by 5 into 8, 40, 11 by 20 outside, and the right side also inside the bracket you do the calculation first. Minus 60 plus 88 divided by 120 by cross multiplication. Then after that, calculate 32 minus 15, 17 by 14, and right side minus 60 plus 88, 28 divided by 160. Again, 11 by 20 is there in the right side, left side, and 4 by 5 is there in the right side. Again, you do these things inside the calculation. Cross multiply again, 340 plus 440 divided by 800, right side 640 plus 140 divided by 800 by cross multiplication. In the left side and right side separate. So 780 divided by 800, right side also 780 divided by 800, LHS is equals to RHS. So remaining parts you can try by yourself in the previous question also. Question number 5. Verify the associative property for multiplication. So the last two questions we are using the operation addition. Now we are just checking the associative property for multiplication. So this is the general form. A into B into C, where B into C in a group. Then right side, A into B into C, where A into B in a group. These are the three rational numbers, 23 by 4, 16 by 69, and 5 minus 5 by 12. A, 23 by 4, B, 16 by 69, and C, minus 5 by 12. Substituting the names, 23 by 4 into 16 by 69 into minus 5 by 12 inside the bracket, and 23 by 4 into 16 by 69 inside the bracket, into minus 15 minus 5 by 12. Then inside the bracket we need to do the calculation first. 23 by 4 into 16 into minus 5 minus 80 divided by 69 into 12, 8, 28. Right side, 23 into 16, 368 divided by 4 into 69, 2, 76 into minus 5 by 12. Then again multiply each other, minus 1840 by 3312 in the left side, right side also minus 1840 divided by 3312 LHS is equals to RHS. Question number 6. Verify the commutative property for product for the following rational numbers. So commutative property for multiplication here. A into B plus B into A. A into B is equals to B into A. That is the general form. According to that, we will check. These are the two rational numbers we have. 22 by 42 minus 16 divided by 121. Substitute the terms. 22 by 42 into minus 16 divided by 121. Right side minus 16 divided by 121 into 22 by 42. Now we will do the calculation. Left side and right side separate. In the left side, after doing the calculation, multiplying, the product is minus 352 divided by 5082. Right side also minus 352 divided by 5082. LHS is equals to RHS. Question number 7. Simplify. We have an operation with rational numbers. We need to simplify, we need to calculate it. Minus 12 divided by 5 plus 3 by 8 minus 6 by 15. So what we are going to do is we will group the terms first. 3 by minus 8 minus 6 by 15 will be in a group. Or you can do it like this. Minus 12 by 5 plus 3 by 8 also can be in a group. If there is 3 rational numbers, 2 rational numbers will consider first, calculate it, then do the operation with the third one. We cannot do the 3 calculations together. So 2 at a time, so 3 by 8 minus 6 by 15 we will do first, then plus minus 12 by 5, or you can do it minus 12 by 5 plus 3 by 8 first, that will be in a group, then minus 6 by 50. So inside the bracket, 45 by minus 48 divided by 120, it is minus 12 by 5 plus minus 3 by 120. Now you can do the cross multiplication between these two rational numbers. It will be minus 1440 minus 15 divided by 600. Then try to make its standard form. What is your answer? Try to make it in the standard form. That is this step, making the standard form. Common factors we find out, divide both terms with the common factors. The final answer will be minus 97 divided by 40. Remember this step, always your answer should be in the standard form or lowest form. Question number 8. Evaluate 3 by 4 minus 2 by 7 plus minus 7 by 4 plus 11 by 14 minus 5 by 8 minus 3 by 7. We are going to calculate this given question. First bracket, 3 by 4 minus 2 by 7. Do the calculation inside the bracket first. It will be after cross multiplying 21 minus 8 divided by 28. Second one, minus 98 plus 44 divided by 56. And next one, 35 minus 24 divided by 56. Then it will be 21 minus 8, 13 divided by 28 plus minus 54 divided by 56 minus 11 by 56. This is our step. Here, 2 at a time, 2 rational numbers we will choose first, then with the third one. So, first 2 terms we will choose and calculate. 13 by 28 plus minus 54 by 56, it is 728 minus 1512 divided by 1516. After doing the cross multiplication, minus 11 by 56 is there outside. One more step, 728 minus 1512 divided by 1568. 728 minus 1512 is minus 728 divided by 1568 minus 11 by 56. Now do the cross multiplication again. Get the large numbers there. Minus 40,768 17,248 divided by 87,808. Now, from this step onwards, we are trying to make the standard form. This is actually the answer, but we need to get the standard form. So, common terms we can find out and divide both numerators and denominators like that. Your final answer should be minus 31 divided by 56. So, till here the steps are finished. Now, just making the standard form by finding the common factors and dividing both numerator and denominator. Now, the question number 9. Verify that 11 by 4 plus 12 by 5 minus 5 by 3 equals to 11 by 4 plus 12 by 5 minus 5 divided by 3. This is associative property. Actually, associative property. Grouping the terms separate. Not exactly the associative. The sign will be changed, but instead of minus plus minus 5 by 3 can be used, and it will be an associative property surely. Check LHS is equals to RHS or not. We need to prove whether LHS is equals to RHS. So first of all, we will do right side and left side together. 11 by 4 plus 12 by 5 in a group minus 5 by 3. Right side 11 by 4 outside, 12 by 5 minus 5 by 3 in a group. Inside the bracket, we will do the calculations first. Cross multiply inside. 5 into 11, 55 plus 4 into 12, 48 divided by 20 minus 5 by 3. Then right side 11 by 4 plus 5 into 12, 3 into 12, 36 minus 5 into 5, 25 divided by 50. Again 55 plus 48, 103 divided by 20 minus 5 by 3. Right side 11 by 4 plus 36 minus 25, 11 divided by 50. Again do the cross multiplication. 3 into 103, 309, 20 into 5, 100 minus 100 divided by 60 is equals to 15 into 11, 165 plus 4 into 11, 44 divided by 60. Again 309 minus 100, 209 divided by 60, and 165 plus 44, 209 by 60. Here LHS is equals to RHS. So we have verified that 11 by 4 plus 12 by 5 inside the bracket minus 5 by 3 is equals to 11 by 4 plus 12 by 5 minus 5 by 3, where 12 by 5 minus 5 by 3 inside the bracket. In all questions we have done only one part. The remaining parts you can try by yourself. Thank you.